Hi, through this video, you will learn the subtopic under Chapter 8, which is Dual Piston Pump. Before that, your presenter is Nurul Irene binti Alias,
Nurul Ain Husna binti Shamsuddin,
Natasha Farihana,
Auza Inur binti Rosni,
and Fariza binti Rahim.
First, let me tell you what is a pump. A pump is a device that is used to transfer fluid such as liquid, gases or solaris. The production of pump is substantially smooth as well as the outflow of liquid at relatively high pressure has two piston assemblies connected in series. In addition, it allows a long, extended suction stroke of sufficient duration to obtain a precise composition of the inlet solvent valve. Now, let me tell you a little bit of history of dual piston pump. The first piston that was setting up was a pressure piston with a long suction stroke and relatively short and abrupt stroke. A distinction has made between pressure pumps and short stroke pumps, depending on whether the pump operation is under pressure or suction. When they were invented at first, the pump was not known as a piston pump. The second piston involved a damper piston, which functioned as a mechanically driven damper to smooth the upflow from the pressure piston. This smoothing is achieved by storing the liquid displaced by the expulsion stroke of the pressure piston and delivering the stroke pressure liquid to the pump outlet during the suction stroke of the pressure suction.
First component of dual piston pump is a suction pipe. Suction pipe is a pipe which takes liquid from the source and provides it to the cylinder of the pump. Next is a suction valve. Suction valve is a non-return valve, which means only one directional flow is possible in this type of valve. This is placed between suction pipe and cylinder of the pump. It is open when suction takes place and closed when the delivery of the water is taking. We move to the third component, which is delivery pipe. It is a pipe which takes water from the pump and provide it to the tank. And then, delivery valve, also non-return valve, placed between cylinder and delivery pipe. It is open when delivery of the water is taking place and closed when suction of the water is taking place. Next is cylinder. Cylinder is made of steel alloy or cast iron. The cylinder is fitted with suction and discharge port, which contains special spring-loaded valve to allow liquid to flow in one direction only, which also similar to check valve. Then, piston is a solid type cylinder part, which move backward and forward inside the cylinder to perform suction and deliverance of liquid. And piston rod work to help the piston to its linear motion. After that, we have a crank. Crank is a solid circular disc which is connected to power source like motor, engine, etc. for its rotation. The connecting rod there is provide connection between crank and the piston and also convert the rotation motion of the crank into the linear motion of the piston. For a strainer, it is a filter-like part provided at the end of the suction pipe to prevent the entrance of solid from water source into the cylinder. And the last one is called as air vessel. Air vessel are a closed container in which the half pipe is filled with water and upper half pipe is filled with compressed air. These air vessels are installed very near to the suction valve and delivery valve to avoid the separation.
As you can see, at the top left side of the slide, it actually the dual piston pump design, whereby it has pump housing and pump jet. The pump works when the piston needs to move back and forth. When the piston moves forward, the gas on the left side of the piston is being compressed and it was pushed to the discharge valve. As the piston moves back, the bottom valve was open so that the liquid can fill the entire stroke.
The application of the pump, firstly in petrochemical industries, for example, hydraulic fracking. When the piston is pushed forward or backward, both suction and expulsion will happen simultaneously with each stroke. This ensures that two inflow pipes and two outflow pipes are needed. The sequence is often reversed when the piston direction is reversed. Next is liquid chromatography. Performance and data can be obtained from the liquid chromatography peak, column and detector depending on the characteristic of the liquid flow given. If the liquid supply to the column and detector is formulated as solvent composition, efficiency also depends on the liquid's accuracy and smoothness of the liquid composition. Next is food processing industry, for example in sugar processing. It enables the movement of ingredients of the foods from one batch to another when using the pump, as well as transport of liquid with different viscosities. Other than that, it also can supply water for food safety and sanitation. Lastly, hand pumps. The air that collected was pushed into tire through the valve. Work is used when pulling the pump handle with a double pressure pump as well as pushing, which is more effort per stroke due to the weight of the air already in the tire.
Now, we will go through the advantages of this pump. First, it has unlimited solvent reservoir. Therefore, it is a long-term use without supervision and quick exchange as well as its cleaning ability. And the third one is, this pump has wide pressure range. Other than that, the changes of pressure and emission rates just give minimal impact on its performance. And the last one is, dual piston pump is skilled in flowing of thick fluids, high gas volume and solid with great control device design. If there are advantages, then this pump also has disadvantages as well, where it is actually heavy due to their large size and weight. Next, the maintenance cost is also expensive. Other than that, the reliability of the pump depends on the cleanliness of the mobile phase, since it has two check valves. And the last one is, this pump will produce a pulsating flow. Now, this is the end of our subtopic, so I would like to thank you for taking the time to listen to our presentation. Stay healthy and enjoy your day!